And now with the following collection of the Swizzy Sound.
So it's one of those days where I'm off from work and bored and feeling in this time and having fun making makeup videos. So I decided to create a very fun, dramatic look. Yes, I know, I love doing that. I love colors and everything. Now, would I wear this in public? Maybe. I don't know if I'll have anything to match with this look, but if you like it and you enjoy it, keep watching the video to learn how to do it. And yeah. And don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. Let's go on to the video, shall we? Enjoy. First and foremost, I started off by applying my UDP paint all over my eyelid up to the brow bone. And then first, I added from my creations of eyeshadows that, so, anyways, it's really like a very rosy light color. It's very light and shimmery, and since rosy colors are in this season, spring and summer season, it's like, why not? Let's use some of it. So I'm applying this right up here where my eyebrow's at and working it down. Very sheer pink. And then work it all over your workspace, which is called the eyelid. And then along with it, I'm going to use the rest of the eyeshadows. I'm going to use are from my Urban Decay palette, the one I got for my birthday. This one right here. I'm going to be using a little bit of Fishnet. And I'm using Peace and Zero. I'm grabbing a little bit of my Fishnet. Very little, and I'm adding that to the bone. My bone right here. And lightly applying. Here. And then blending it downwards. Don't worry, it's not gonna show that much. You don't have to use this, but use the Peace color wet. Whatever you use to make it eyeshadow wet. So the Urban Decay eyeshadow transforming potion, and using the wide line brush of it, and then move it around into your Peace color eyelid, but you don't want it to touch to your crease at all. Avoid getting involved with your crease at the moment. You have time to it afterwards. I'm talking about my eyelid like it's a relationship. I'm gonna take your crease brush, and in my case this is my crease brush, and grab Zero, and I'm going to do my interpretation of cutting the crease. So here we go. I'm applying it right here between these two colors in the crease area, like so. Now this is what I think cutting the crease means. I've watched a couple videos to give myself the 411 about cutting the crease, and this is what I come up with and think what it is. So if it's not, don't hate. This is the way I interpretate. Does that make any sense? That was so lame, I'm sorry. Interpretate, whatever. Now blend the crease in. Windshield wiper motion. Blend it up because you want it to be smoky-licious. I'm sorry guys, I'm really extremely bored here. Okay. Blend it even upwards, combining it with the Fishnet color. Like so. Looks like I just, my color stay from Revlon. Good stuff, good stuff. And I'm going to use the same technique I learned from Sarah Victor. As you can see, that's what I did. So it's kind of like a little retro-ish cat eye liner style. So the more you do it, the more it's practiced, the more you get better, right? So that's what's going on right here. So I'm going to start and just lightly tug at the end of your eyelid where the crease ends right here. Line down. Alrighty, after I finish applying my eyeliner, ta-da, I'm going to show you how I fill in my eyebrows with my Benefit Browsings. I probably did show it before, I'm not sure if I did. Anyways, first you take your angled brush that comes in a kit. Excuse me. Grab some of your colored wax first. Start from the end. Fill it in. Slowly but surely, just fill it in the right arch, to the arch of your eyebrow. You can always just put the wax on and not put the rest of the color in, but it's up to you. However you fill in your eyebrows, you know. And then grab the powdery part, the color. I don't know what you call this part, I'm sorry. I've gone blank. Fill it in lightly across the eyebrow and there you go, fill in your eyebrow. Alrighty, and then for lip gloss I'm using from Sephora, one of my samples, and Precious Pink, which means I am going back to Sephora and getting the lip glosses that I got in that free birthday gift, because they're so nice. Now, this is a very nice glossy look to finish it. Then add your mascara to finish off the look. You may put your blush that you want, of choice that you want. It's up to you. I'm not putting blush because, like I said, my cheeks are naturally rosy, posy. Yes, I'm using my Colossal. Back to what I like. Yeah, my Colossal does me no wrong. Now, to make it even more dramatic, you can go ahead and add black eyeliner to your bottom lids, which I might do just to finish it. But you guys have seen me with black eyeliner on both top and bottom lids, so you guys get the picture. So hope you guys enjoyed this fun look, playful look. I would go out in this look. I normally won't, but I like it. Hope you guys do too, and don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe.
Let's have some fun, this beat is sick. I wanna take a ride on your disco stick. Let's have some fun, this beat is sick. I wanna take a ride on your disco stick. I wanna kiss you, but it's